Monopoly Junior, How to Play. The object of the game is to have the most cash when the first player goes bankrupt. Setup. Lay out the board, and each player picks a token and places it on go. Take the matching character card and 12 sold signs and place them in front of you. Pick one player to be the banker. The banker is in charge of the cash in the bank, which they must keep separate from their own. In a two-player game, give each player 20 cash. In a three-player game, give each player 18 cash. And in a four-player game, give each player 16 cash. Shuffle the chance deck and place it face down on the chance spot on the board. The youngest player goes first, then play proceeds clockwise. On your turn, roll the die and move your token that number of spaces clockwise around the board. You may not move counterclockwise. Every time your token passes or lands on go, collect 2 cash from the bank. If you land on a chance space, take the top chance card from the deck, read it aloud, then do what it says, putting the card back under the deck. If you land on an unowned property, you must buy it. Pay the bank its purchase price as indicated on the space. Put one of your sold signs on the space so everyone knows who owns it. If you land on a space that a player owns, you must pay them rent as indicated by the price written on the space. If you own the space, you pay nothing. If a player owns both properties of the same color, then rent is double the amount written on those spaces. If you land on go to jail, then you move your token to jail. You do not pass go, and you do not collect 2 cash. At the start of your next turn, pay 1 cash or use a get out of jail free card, if you have one. Then, roll the die and move as normal. You are still allowed to collect rent while you are in jail. If you move and land on the jail space, then you are just visiting and not actually in jail. If you land on free parking, then nothing happens. After following the rules for the space you landed on, your turn ends. Pass the die clockwise and the next player goes. If you don't have enough cash to pay rent, buy a property you land on, or pay a chance card fee, then you are bankrupt and the game ends. The other players count their cash, and the player with the most cash wins. If there is a tie, then the tied players count how much their properties are worth and add it to their total to determine a winner. Once you have mastered the standard rules, you can play with these advanced rules. If you don't have enough cash to pay rent or a chance card fee, you must pay the player or bank the remaining with property you own based on its price. After that, if you still can't pay, then you are bankrupt, and the game ends and the player with the most cash wins.